Let me ask you a question.
Which band?
I give you two choice.
Which one?
I give you two choice, sir. Let me ask you a question, sir.
Why don't you answer the question?
Let me ask you a question, sir.
Which Bible?
Let me ask you a question.
Ask him.
Sir, can I ask you a question, please?
Which Bible?
I will give you two choice. Two man. One man who is bewitched, and another man who is the holy man.
What
whom do you follow?
Man?
3 years Jesus' life.
One Jesus and another God.
Sir, you are two men. One is bewitched and the other one is the holy man. Whom do you follow as human being? Whom do you follow? A bewitched man or a holy man?
A holy man.
Aisha tell us that Muhammad was bewitched.
Sacks in your Bible, in the book of Genesis, chapter
30. I'll give you the reference.
Fact check.
Father had sex with his two daughters in your Bible. Now turn it off.
I will give you the hadith, the reference. When Aisha said,
yeah.
I saw, listen.
He saw who, Pastor?
Sahih al-Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari. Book 3175. Book 58. Hadith 17. Volume 4. Book 53. Hadith 400. Look what Aisha says. Aisha says, one is the prophet was bewitched, so that he began to imagine that he had done a sin, which is in fact he had not done.
Wow. Is that true?
Excuse me.
Is that
now,
true?
Answer the question.
Is that true?
Was Jesus a man?
So called. Muhammad was bewitched according to Aisha.
Can you tell us about the sex?
What is that? Hey!
I got your reference.
What is the weight of sin?
I got the reference. I got the reference.
Monsieur, take something. Hey,
Muhammad was bewitched.
Can you stop lying?
That's why I give you the reference. I give you the reference.
Which Bible?
I give you the reference.
Which
Bible? That's why I left Islam. That's why I gave my life to Jesus Christ. Not only that. Hold on. Look what Muhammad says.
What does he say?
Look what Muhammad says.
What did he say?
What is the wage of sin?
Answer. What is the wage of sin?
Answer.
Death.
Answer.
Did Jesus die?
Sahih al-Bukhari again. The hadith of Muhammad.
Sahih
al-Bukhari. Book 71.
No, if he died,
the book of medicine, narrated by Abdullah bin Umar. Muhammad said, the prophet of Islam. Muhammad said, there is neither atha, nor tayara, and an evil omen. But insisting, a horse,
a woman,
and a house. There is no evil, Muhammad said, there is no evil but in this three, a horse, a woman, and a house. And our Muslim friend says, Muhammad had a divine wisdom. Where is divine wisdom?
Did Mary give birth to God?
Where is divine wisdom in Muhammad when he said, there is no evil but in this three? A horse, a woman,
a horse,
and a house.
And a house.
No only that.
Okay, that's good wisdom.
No only that.
La ilaha illallah.
No only that. Listen what he said.
There is no God but one.
La ilaha illallah.
There is no God but one Allah.
La ilaha illallah.
Shut up.
La ilaha illallah.
Quiet.
Sahih al-Bukhari, I will give you the reference if you want. Look what he said.
What does he say, Pastor?
محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. لا اله الا الله.
جو يا دمكي يا وسط.
لا اله الا الله.
محمد said when a Muslim pray, if there is not a sandal in front of you and a black dog and a donkey and a woman passed in front of you, your prayer is not valid. You must go and have an evolution and come back to pray. And they asked Muhammad, why not yellow dog, why not red dog, but black dog? And Muhammad said, a black dog is a devil. Well, black man. Muhammad said in a hadith, a black man came out of the left shoulder of Adam and a white man came out of the right shoulder of Adam. And he said, a black man will go to hell, I do not care. And a white man will go to heaven, I do not care.
Allah,
and by the way,
how can God be arrested?
By the way, Muhammad said, three quarters women, Muslim women, he said three quarters of hellfire is full of women. A three quarter of hellfire is full of women. The question is, my friend, why did Muhammad say three quarters of hellfire is full of women?
How can God be buried in a grave? How can God be buried in a grave? If Jesus was God,
Muhammad said, two women equal to one man. If one of them make an error, the other one correct him. He says, because of the deficiency in your mind, don't you know when you have your menstruation, you cannot pray, you cannot fast. Women, Muslim women, when you have your menstruation, you cannot pray, you cannot fast because of the deficiency in your mind, because of the deficiency in your religion. Don't you know your husband can beat you? Don't you know a Muslim husband can beat his wife? Where is divine wisdom in beating a wife? I'm asking you, sir. Where is divine wisdom in beating women? My Muslim friend said, Muhammad, how did he say wisdom? I'm asking you a question. Where is divine wisdom in beating a woman?
He gives us the information that Muhammad
stopped.
Right,
here
we go.
The Muhammad beat his wife. Thank you, brother.
Preach it,
a true man
preach it.
Never beat his wife. But
how can God die?
Is that true or not?
Did Jesus die?
Is that true?
Did Jesus die?
I'm asking you, Brother Cain, where is divine wisdom in beating women?
That wisdom comes from the pit. That's where it comes from. And Muhammad pick it up and give it to Muslims. And they don't realize that it's a fake, a fraud, a phony. That's what it is.
Was God buried in a grave?
The Bible tells us.
Revelation
man and a woman shall leave their parents and both will become one flesh. And the Bible tells us, Jesus said, husband, love your wives as Christ has loved the church. But in the Quran, a Muslim husband can and will beat his wife.
Why can he beat his wife?
Because Allah commanded.
Yes, but why though?
He said, those
because
women,
he's afraid.
Yes,
Why is he afraid of? He's afraid that his wife will disobey him. That's why.
How can God die?
She hasn't disobeyed him yet.
How can God die?
She hasn't disobeyed him yet.
How can God die?
But he's afraid she will disobey him. This is in the Quran. Allah said, if you fear disobedience. Someone tell me I'm lying.
Yeah, what Jesus a Jew?
You're a Muslim.
What God a Jew?
You are living in fear every day in the week. You can't go into the toilet because you think your toilet is haunted.
Well, Jesus went to the toilet, you say it's God.
You can't sleep with your wife because you think if you don't pray that Satan's going to do your wife before you. Someone tell me I'm lying.
Oh, liar. Oh, God, I'm
lying.
Liar. Everything I say, I have proof. Everything I say, I have proof. Nice. Listen, yes, family, just look at everything I say up on the internet. You will know they are the liars like their prophet.
Why are you living in fear?
You're a shaitan.
Why are you living in fear of the truth?
You're a shaitan.
I don't want the small fry.
No.
I don't want Lamin that comes here every week with his, he's been laminated. That's where my paper boy, not I. Yeah? I don't want him. I don't want to debate him. You know why? You know why? Because Lamin is like a broken record. Debate. Like a broken record. Every week, the point in my face. They have nothing to say. I don't want Abbas to debate Abbas. Because Abbas, he's been fighting my CP every week. I don't want him.
I'm here. You know why?
I want the big fish. Someone bring me Shamsi. Someone bring me Muhammad Hijab. Someone bring me Hashim. And I will expose Islam today as a fake religion from the devil. I challenge any scholar here. Any Muslim scholar to debate me right now.
Okay. I'm here. Stop. I'm a scholar. Come here.
He's a scholar.
He's running away. He's running away. A big man. Big muscles. Where is the brain?
No brain.
Jesus.
I
is the everlasting.
But I will open it.
He is the one
with
the spiritual strength.
Look at this man here.
That gives us the Holy Spirit.
Look, I give you a question.
Stand amongst wolves.
He doesn't know.
Like love. And not move.
I didn't tell the Bible.
And who let him do his heckle?
He doesn't know. Heckle is evil.
I will prove to you now.
Who is heckle here?
What?
Who is heckle here? He can't debate. My brother. Empty barrels. Empty barrels. Make them all sound.
Promise you that you're going to go to hell and you're going to burn. Are you looking forward
to debate?
You're burning in hell. Jesus promises us eternal life. Oh dear Muslims, what Allah has promised you is that you're going to go to hell. First, are you Muslim? Did you know that that's what your Quran, that's what Allah has promised you? You're not going to Jannah first. Trust me. You want me to prove it to you? From your own Quran. Will you leave Islam today? Will you leave Islam today?
I'll tell you. Jesus buried in a grave.
Tell us the answer.
How can God be buried in a grave?
Be quiet.
How can God be buried in a grave?
Be quiet.
How can God be buried in a grave?
Was Jesus God?
Yeah, answer.
Was God?
Was a Jew God?
Was Jesus God?
How can a Jew be God?
We're talking about eternal life.
How can... Okay.
I want to debate a scholar.
Okay.
Debate. I'm going to read what Quran to you. And if you're a man, which I believe you are, you're going to stand here and you're going to listen. He's laughing because he doesn't even know he's going to hell. He doesn't even know he promised hellfire.
You're Allah's scared
of Jesus created Mary.
You're Allah's scared of
Jesus.
1 second, Baba.
Did Jesus create Mary?
I don't want no nonsense.
You're an angel.
Listen to what I'm going to read you from the Quran. See, they're afraid of their own book.
How can a Jew
be afraid of your own book?
How can a Jew be?
You should be ashamed of hearing this.
That's
not a Muslim. You're scared of it. Let me just read. I'm going to read that every Muslim is going to go to hellfire and be burnt to a crisp. This is the promise they have from Allah. They haven't been promised Jannah first. They have to burn first. All the limbs, flesh, blood, joint, ligaments are burnt to a crisp.
How can God die?
You're Allah scared of
God.
You're Allah scared of God. Puppy.
You're lying.
Oh, okay. Am I lying?
Yeah.
Sahih Bukhari is telling me.
How can you say God was buried in a grave?
Huh?
How can you say God was buried in a grave?
The puppy was back under the bed of Muhammad. So he stopped the revelation.
For coming.
Because of small puppies.
This
is the promise that Muslims have been given by their fake God. This is from a Sahih Hadith, Sahih Muslim. And this is an excerpt from Book 1, Hadith 349. Again, Book 1, Hadith 349.
Allah is scared of small puppies.
They, the angels, will recognize in the fire.
Let
me start again. They will recognize them in the fire. See, he's instead. Panic attack. Come over here.
I can do nothing.
They will recognize them in the fire.
I can do nothing.
For hellfire will devour everything of the sons of Adam. That's every Muslim.
If Jesus was
God, how did he die? That stupid mark of prostration.
If Jesus was God, how did he die?
Allah has forbidden
God,
who is scared of the fire to consume the mark of prostration. They will be taken out of the fire. All Muslims will be taken out of the fire.
Which Bible?
Burnt.
Which Bible?
They will be taken out of the fire, burnt, and the water of life will be poured on them. Now, Muslims,
which Bible?
You may get to go to Jannah, but you've got to burn first. You've got to burn first. Are you looking forward to burning first?
You can't
Are you looking forward
question.
To burning first?
You can't answer the question.
Come on. We're the proud Muslims that are looking forward to burning in hell first.
Allah
is scared.
Allah. Excuse me.
Allah.
Jesus.
Allah.
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 You only have to believe in Jesus Christ. Your Savior, and you have eternal life.
Allah,
look at the channel, what I've read. He promised that you're going to burn from Sahih Muslim. Authentic Hadith, that's where you're going. You're going to burn.
Did Jesus die? Did Jesus die?
Take it seriously, Muslim.
How can God die?
This is my brother. They're not even listening to him.
You're a loser.
Gabriel is afraid of a puppy.
Excuse me.
Did you know?
Excuse me.
He's afraid of a little chihuahua.
Was Jesus arrested?
Gabriel, according to Muhammad, who stands in the presence of God, is afraid of a puppy. You know why? Muhammad was waiting for revelation from Gabriel. This is true in your Sahih Hadith. And he was waiting for Gabriel to come, and Gabriel didn't turn up. But they don't want to know. I'm going to save this one. Fact is, a little chihuahua was under the bed of Muhammad. Muhammad was waiting all day for Gabriel to turn up with a wahi revelation. Yeah? Gabriel didn't come.
And
then Muhammad had to go. Gabriel, where you been? Gabriel said,
Catholic Bible.
The puppy prevented me from coming in. So you can imagine. Gabriel turns up at the door.
78 books.
He hears a yapping chihuahua. He don't want to go in. No. I ain't going in there.
Which Bible?
Allah said, go on. Go in. He don't want to go in.
Which Bible? How can God die?
What a load of fuss. What a load of rubbish.
How can God die? Conquer God's time.
What a load of rubbish.
All come to Jesus Christ.
Look at him run. Look at him run.
Answer my question. Answer my
look at him run. Somebody come and tell me I'm lying.
Finger up, look at him run.
Look at him, come over here.
God be
in Jesus' name, come over here. Look what Allah does to people.
Asking questions, see?
Look what Allah does
asking
to people.
Asking questions, see? I say, coming to me.
Put a picture on this man. God bless him.
He's coming to
Allah
me.
Allah
strips to me.
You he's of brother. Your identity.
As I say,
only he strips you. Of
empty
your blackness,
make the most sound. He's stripped
you of your heritage.
You see,
he strips you
away from me.
Of everything you know above your ancestry. And he turned you into a fake Arab.
I'm shouting. You see, I came to him, he ran away. Now he's coming to me. But now he's attacking Zakaria.
Man,
Zakaria, who's Arab?
He come from Arabia.
This is what he said. Do you stand it?
This is Kristalina.
You come from Arabia.
Repeat with me. Debate with me.
He said, look at me, man.
Why
that's his
him?
Reply.
Why
you ain't feeding
the Lord? Come out of Islam.
I'm debating.
Run to Jesus Christ.
What did you say?
Run to Jesus. Run from Islam.
Why did Jesus about himself?
Look at you.
Why your God is white?
Look at you, bro.
Why your God is white?
Why Jesus about himself? He doesn't know.
Why your God is white?
He doesn't know what Jesus. He doesn't know.
Why your God is white?
He does. He's bilingual.
Why your God is white?
We only know Arabic.
I'm here. Why your God is white?
Let Allah only know Arabic.
Your God is supremacist.
Do the Bible.
Why
you
let
him the Bible?
Take away everything that you are.
Look at.
You let him take away your love
with his wife.
You let him take away your identity. You let him take away everything that you know as a black man.
Look at him.
Is your God ashamed to be a black man?
You are.
Is your God ashamed
to know the man you are?
Look at him.
Why your God is white?
You from your identity.
He can't debate.
Why your God is white?
The man can't debate.
You
empty barrel.
You have been. You have gone from slavery. Into slavery. Arabize.
The white man who bring for you the
Arabize.
When you are slave.
Look at him now.
Who bring for you the Christianity?
His identity has been stolen. He can't answer me. He can't answer me. He can't answer me. This is how sad. This is how sad. Excuse me. This is how. This, okay, come on, mate. Debate me. Run. I'll give him 5 minutes to run. I'll give you 5 minutes before you run. I'm asking you a question. Do you agree
that
his identity has been stripped?
Why are you dressed as a white
man? Here. No, don't. Wait. Answer my question or move.
Why are you dressed as a white man? I'm African. Hey.
Right, that's not my question. My question is, do you agree that his identity has been stripped?
No, I'm African. Talk to me.
Are you,
talk to me. I speak my language.
No.
I speak my language.
Okay, so you don't agree.
How can God die?
His freedom.
Why is it?
No, his identity.
Identity.
He's a Jamaican man. He's an Arab.
So you want him to...
I'm asking you a question. You see how these poor Muslims can't answer no question?
You're just a white man.
Ignorant. This man is ignorant. He doesn't even know his own Quran a bit.
So you want him to be a stereo...
I suggest...
Stereotypical Arab.
Stereotypical Arab. That's what Allah has done to him.
Yes, colonized.
I speak my language.
Christ God,
what is your language?
God, the real God in heaven, wants to develop your own personality. He wants to know the person that you are. He doesn't want to strip you of your identity. He said, come unto me, all those who are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
So how are you
He didn't give him rest, he put him in more grief. Look at him hide behind his camera.
How are you dying? How are you
look at him, proud of the mark of prostration.
Yeah.
Go and mess up his head. Five times a day. Look at him, he's laughing. He's laughing at his own Muslim because he knows it's foolishness.
Why are you dressed like a white man?
He can do what he wants.
Me, brother.
He can do what he wants.
This man, let him, hold on.
I'm here
let me tell you something. You see this man here? Before I got to the park, it was him who inspired me. You know why? Because he was preaching the gospel. Look at him now.
Look at him now.
It's better, alhamdulillah. It's better.
Look at him now.
It's better.
He's at the bed.
With a towel on his head.
My brother's a white man.
Look at him now.
He's ready.
Proud to stand in the corner.
He's ready.
And speak Arabic so everyone can hear him.
Okay, he's ready. He's ready.
Where's your moderator?
Trinity.
Moderator.
Moderator.
Yeah. No, we don't want shouting. 3 minutes.
No, no, no. Come on, come on.
He's back in
Because he knows the foundations of Islam are being decimated by the truth today.
Alhamdulillah, I'm a Muslim. But I'm not worshipping the religion of who enslaved me. I don't worship the religion of who enslaved me.
About a debate. I don't want to talk to hecklers. I want to talk to you.
Why are you worshipping us, a white supremacist?
He's a pebble.
Allah. Yeah.
Can we make an agreement about a debate?
Yes.
You choose a topic. I choose the topic.
That's fair.
But the topic has to be 50-50.
Yeah.
50-50.
My topic.
No, one 50, question, 50. One question.
My topic.
Yeah, 50-50.
One question, one question.
No question. 50-50 topic.
See the fear.
No proper debate.
I'm trying to guide him
to
away from the Bible. Trouble.
No, he will run away.
My topic. My topic.
One question, one question.
My topic. My topic.
One question, one
question. Muhammad being Satan's puppet.
But that's the topic.
That's my topic. Okay. What's your topic?
Hold on,
Why is this man?
You want to debate?
I mean, he's protecting the big fake shake.
You want to debate me? It's the will of Jesus. The will of God or the will of Satan?
Any topic I
do. You see how he's afraid to debate me?
Any topic?
You see? I'm going to wait today, and I'm going to wait for Shamsi. I'm going to wait for Muhammad Hijab. Right?
He's pure love.
But I mean business.
Why are
I'm waiting for the ones who are not scholars to lie to you. I'm waiting for them.
Because he knows me.
He's here.
I love this game. Great to be back in the park. Peace and love to everybody.
Come
I love these Muslims, but that's the way you have to handle them. I offer him a debate.
Come to debate.
Two topics. He's proud enough to come and chant the Quran for everyone to see him.
No, be scared.
He's proud enough to say to my brothers and sisters, may Allah destroy you. But when I offer him a debate, Muhammad Amin has to protect him. Little Muhammad Amin has to protect the big sheikh.
But why do you challenge me to a debate?
So I urge you guys, come to Jesus. You will fear no one. No man. No beast. In the heaven or the earth or the earth below. For Jesus gives you the Holy Spirit. You know what? Not in my strength.
The Holy Spirit is only through the man.
Just trust.
He has his
story. They were the truth.
He knows how to expose him.
Why you choosing?
He challenged me to debate. Run away.
Why you choosing to debate?
You can't look at me. But every week
he's going to debate him. Okay, slaughter me. Slaughter me again. Slaughter me. Slaughter me again.
I'm bringing you.
I told you that topic of my debate.
It's the will of God and me with the will of Satan.
I can't believe it. He's scared. The man is scared to debate.
Come on, this rubbish you're following.
You
make them influence you.
I'm telling you, but you're a good man.
Is that what the white supremacists do to you? The greatest example. I want to talk about him. And I'm going to prove today that he was a fake. And I'm going to prove today that he was a fraud.
Bring your scholars here.
Bring them.
And
I'm going to prove today that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through him.
They call Muhammad
the
last prophet.
Are you looking forward to going to hell?
Yes.
Are you looking
for
to
heaven? I'm going to hell.
They call Muhammad a lost prophet, but I call him a lost prophet. Lost prophet.
Say again.
They call Muhammad a lost prophet.
No, he's
by the L-O-S-T.
Lost prophet.
He's a lost prophet.
You're a lost prophet.
L-O-S-T. Lost prophet.
Muslim, please.
Muhammad is a lost prophet.
It's a joke thing, but it ain't really a joke thing. I'm telling you the truth here. You don't even, you see, you grow your beard like him, but you don't know about him, do you? Because all they tell you is what they tell you in the mosque. Oh, he's wonderful, he's beautiful. Have you read the Quran? Okay. Have you read the Hadith?
They are not giving the copy.
Okay, you know you're supposed to...
No, I'm a
pastor. You want to have a conversation? Do you know you're supposed to follow your Hadith, the Sunnah? Sorry? You're not Muslim.
Hey, the Holy Spirit is not working.
I asked him.
The Holy Spirit is not working.
No,
he didn't respond.
If he read the Quran, he went, yes. When I went to the Sunnah, he went, no. I'm not Muslim. Are you Muslim or not?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
You asked me if I'd read the Quran, and if you're a Christian...
Why have you read the Quran?
Why? Because I'm interested.
Okay, and what did you find out about it?
I found out that it wasn't the truth.
You found out it wasn't the truth?
Yeah.
Good man. Good man.
So now I'm a good man.
No, I tell you... are you going to walk away?
You're giving Christ...
Are you going to walk away? Are you going to walk away? Oh! Listen, I'm giving Christ a bad name. Does it sound like a Muslim to you? Does it sound like a Muslim to you?
You're not coming with knowledge.
He's standing with the Muslims. He's got a script of a Muslim. And he's got a tequila of a Muslim. And he tries to fool. He tries to fool a Christian that know better.
Jesus,
I know better. I've read the Quran and the Hadith.
Jesus,
and I know that you can lie to us. And smile in our faces and hate us in your heart.
So we are
true. Is that true?
You're a fool for following your fake prophet.
And we are here to rebuke the Satan.
Why are you lying?
We are here to rebuke the Satan.
The Holy Ghost is lying.
We are here to rebuke the Satan.
Why is he protecting the Muslims?
Just like my
Why
Jesus
is
did.
To the Muslim?
Just like my Jesus did, he rebuked the Satan. He said, get me behind me, Satan.
It's good to see Brother Kane
get
back in the
ball.
Get
me behind me,
Satan. Spreading the word
like
of the Lord.
The
Logos is strong.
Glory to God. I'm only here to set the captives free.
Amen, brother.
Amen. Amen.
Not here to fight. I'm here to fight the good fight.
Yes.
But I'm here to set you free, bro.
Spiritual battle.
I'm here to set you free. You don't know you're in bondage. See him laughing. Yeah. Come, come and speak to me then. Come speak. Salam alaikum. Do you know your hold on. This man just said to me, Salam alaikum. You know your prophet said you shouldn't say that first.
What well, yes. Jesus said yes. when you greet each other.
Hold on. Say that. You know your prophet told
what
you.
What are you talking about?
Jesus said, no. I've asked you a question.
Salam alaikum.
Did you know your prophet said you can't greet us first? Okay. Now.
What you say?
It doesn't matter what your prophet said.
It don't matter what you said.
Your prophet said that.
It don't matter what you say. You don't know.
Yo, I'm quoting your prophet. Are you saying it doesn't matter what your prophet said? Pull him out of the fire. Go and pull him.
You see me?
Pull him.
And you come and ask me this question.
See how they're so afraid to engage in a conversation. I've said to him.
Hello, bro.
Mansoor.
Scared. Oh, he's already scared.
After all this time, Mansoor, we've never met, my friend.
Let's start the word.
We never met, my friend. Hello, hello. We never.
Allah, who does not have a spirit. Allah,
a great Muslim scholar.
Allah, who does not have a spirit.
We love you, Mansoor.
Allah, he's the one looking for. He's the one looking for weak Christians.
He's an idol here.
Every week, right? And putting his propaganda on this stupid little channel of his to make Christianity look bad. When you can't do that, come and talk to a Christian that knows something.
Come on, be courageous.
Don't be as a friend.
Don't be
a friend. I come to you. I come to you respectfully. I'm asking you to debate me. Right? I choose a topic. You choose a topic. Look at the fear. His own scholar, the great Islamic Park scholar,
for 25 years he's coming
hiding from me. You know why? You know why he's hiding?
Because,
no, hold on. You know why he's hiding? It's not because of nothing about me. It's because he knows I know the truth. And he doesn't want it to be known.
Yeah?
That paper boy said, can't hack the hack. This man is offended. By what I'm saying. That Christianity is a hash.
Why are you angry?
Okay. Everything cool. He said no. Would you like to have a debate?
Wait.
Away from the camera.
I want the world to see the truth.
Do you want the world to see the truth? Let the world decide who's speaking the truth, me or you. We've got the cameras here. See how they run? See how they run from the cameras?
Three blind mice.
See how they run. Glory to God.
Yes, praise
glory
God.
To God.
Praise
hallelujah.
His
bless His holy name. Are you serious? A serious question. Am I a Christian?
I just moved to London, that's why.
Okay.
In the States. And I will see you on YouTube. Just remembering that you are a Christian, correct?
Couldn't you work it out?
100%, yeah, you are. Okay, would you be subject to higher learning in terms of stepping up,
before you go
stepping
there,
out of the world of religion and spirituality?
Before you go there, are you Muslim?
I am, no, I'm not.
Are you native?
No, I'm not.
Agnostic?
I am something called Druze, by blood.
Okay, hold on a minute.
No.
Brother, listen. On another occasion, right? Because the Lord has just driven me here to rebuke Islam and lift His name up. That's why I'm here. On another day, I'm willing to have this conversation.
Oh, yes, sure.
Maybe I need to read up on what you believe.
No, I don't believe. You ask me what I am. What do I believe?
Are you listening? You're agnostic?
Yeah, I'm agnostic. Okay, basically, I believe in
something.
Higher power. I think whether you look at it in a quantum physics point of view or a spirituality point of view, I think it's becoming obvious that we're all brothers and sisters. There's a holofractographic universe we're all connected to.
Okay, this is diversion tactic.
So what I'm trying to tell you
is, my brother, shake my hand.
Spirituality is higher than religion.
Nice talking to you.
You know what I mean?
I'm not on that tip at the minute, with all due respect. I'm not on that tip.
He's not been taught to debate you in the church.
All you can call me is a liar, are you?
What do you mean?
He's not been taught to debate agnostic people. All his aim is to come and attack Muslims. That's all his game.
That's right. Yeah, that's no, not Muslims. Get it right. Islam.
Islam. Islam.
Not Muslims. I'm coming here to free Muslims.
Freedom from what?
Yeah, freedom from hellfire where you're going.
And where do you want them to go?
I want them to go to the real heaven.
Which is where?
Which is up there with Jesus.
No Jesus.
Amen. This is what he's promised you, bro. But listen, hold on. Did you hear the hadith I read?
No, I didn't. I didn't hear what you said, okay?
Okay.
Every Muslim with burning hell before
going to Jannah. Yeah, did you hear that hadith?
No, it doesn't say that.
It doesn't say that.
Okay.
It'll pass by hell.
It doesn't say that.
It'll pass by hell.
But he's a Shia, okay. So
he's not... No, I'm not a Shia. I'm a Sunni.
Ah, sorry.
Oh. Yeah.
Apologies. So, okay, so show me...
So don't make too much accusations, you know? I know it's Christianity, it's good to lie.
No, I didn't recall you...
Who's the true one? Who's the true one?
You debate the paper, you say Shia. Okay, you stay.
I'll debate you next time. And who's the true one?
I want to speak about Islam. That's why I'm here.
That's what he's
saying. Yeah, that's it. But for the moment, maybe later in the day, we can talk.
I think I've
okay, brother. I'm going to read you the hadith.
No, just tell us now.
I'm not going to leave the hadith. I'm not going to leave the hadith.
You're supposed to follow the sunnah.
So
yeah, I know.
Right, so I'm going to read you the sunnah. Let me read you the sunnah first.
Your aim was to free us.
You see, he don't want to hear the sunnah.
Now he wants to take your claim back.
No. I want to prove my claim by your own sources.
Which is your claim? What's your claim?
Sahih Muslim.
No, what's your claim?
My claim is...
What's your... Why you...
Allah... Yeah, has tricked you into believing to him. And I'll tell you why. Because what he's done, because he's so stupid, he's actually promised you fire first before heaven.
So what does your God promise us?
He's promised you that you're going to burn first.
So what did your God promise?
No, hold on.
You're going to free us from this.
I heard what you said. Is that not a problem to you?
No, it's not a problem now.
But
anyways, tell me now, where do you want to take us to? You want to take Muslims to where?
So you don't actually care.
To Jesus.
You don't care.
That's why I want
to care.
Now I care to hear where you're going to take us to.
Have you ever turned the tap on when it's too hot?
Alive and TR.
Yeah, when it's too hot and you felt your skin burn. And you move your hand away because it's so hot.
Yes.
Yeah? That's your whole body fire, inhale, burning. This is what your God promised you.
Well, I'm interested.
That's
now,
not a problem to you.
It's not about Islam.
No, I'm
you
asking
said I'm
you. Is that a problem
from
to you?
Islam to take you somewhere else.
Is that a problem?
I want
to
know where I'm going to go.
I'm asking him a question if it's a problem to him. Now, this is a brainwashed Muslim, I'm speaking to you, God bless him. Because he can't engage because he doesn't actually know anything or he doesn't care.
That's what it means to the next chapter.
No, I will talk about
this
chapter.
Which is where you're going to take us to. That's where I'm going.
Heaven.
Okay.
Don't divert the topic. Jesus. Don't divert the topic. I'm talking about Islam.
Is Hitler one of those who are going to heaven also or no?
Hitler was not a Christian.
He wasn't a Christian.
No. How? What do you mean how?
Why
I've got no time for
because you do not follow. People. He did not follow.
I've got no time for Muslims practicing taqiyya, like wanting to divert people away from the topic of Islam because they know that I'm exposing it. I've got no time for people talking nonsense and I can't engage in a conversation. I want to talk to honest Muslims who are interested in refuting what I'm saying.
He claims he was a Christian. How do you know?
Hallelujah.
Hitler was not a Christian because of Galatians 3:28. Read Galatians 3:28. I know Hitler was not a Christian. Can we hear Brother Cain? I'm right here, Brother Cain.
I don't know how you guys are denying Hitler's Christianity. He claims he was Christian.
Look at this man here. Is anyone Muslim? See? I said. You, who's body? Oh, scary! So scary! Hold on.
Okay, let's get out. Let's be
serious. Boy, you're scary, man. You're scary, man. Hold on.
No, he's getting close.
So you're gonna take us to heaven or not?
Brother, listen. Your prophet has taught you to lie. I don't care. He taught you to lie, and I don't want to speak to you about it anymore.
I'm just here to tell you, I'm not a Muslim.
You're not a Muslim.
Well,
then go and find out something more about Islam.
No, you were just talking about me saying something that wasn't true.
Shall I tell you the point?
It wasn't true.
Okay,
he say on camera that I was a Muslim? Did he ask you on camera? Did he tell you that I was a Muslim?
Yes. And I'm saying it again.
I'm making mistakes. Because when you speak, you must speak the truth.
I'm saying it again.
Speaking the truth.
But if you're not a Muslim,
you're an undercover Muslim.
I'm an undercover Muslim. So what are you? An undercover Christian?
No, he's not. He's a Christian warrior.
Are you pretending to be
the word of Christ?
Are you pretending to be a Christian?
Brother, why did you put your beard like that? Why you following a man? Why are you following a man that slept with a 6 year old?
Talk to me.
He fondled.
No, tell him why you're having a problem.
Does that make you proud? Watch them run. Watch them run. Look, look, look. He's not Muslim. As soon as I mention Muhammad fondling Aisha when she's 6, he runs away.
How old was Mary when she got married to Joseph?
I don't know, brother. How old is
she? You have to know. You're Christian.
How old is she?
You have Christian. You should know.
Why do you care?
The Bible. The Bible. The Bible. He's not interested in the answer.
Okay, go ahead.
The Bible doesn't say how old Mary was.
Is it?
But. Mary was a virgin, right?
How old was she?
When she had Jesus.
How old was she?
The Bible doesn't say.
How old was she?
Okay, he's had his answer.
I asked the age, the number.
The broken record.
I asked the number.
Everyone. The Bible doesn't say. Now, in old Jewish custom,
Joseph when he
married in old Jewish custom, it was custom for...
This guy doesn't know
let's
nothing.
Say...
Is he here for the cover?
Young girls, virgins, yeah? To be betrothed. At a young age.
Young?
Yeah?
What's
this
young?
This is the truth. Yeah?
Define young. What's young?
Now, the Bible, as I said, the Bible doesn't say how old Mary was.
But what's defined young?
Right?
Define young.
But we do know.
Underage.
Right? That she wasn't 6.
How old is she? How do you know that?
We do know.
How do you know that?
Right? Because it was not Jewish custom to marry your daughter off at 6 years old.
What's the Jewish custom? Okay? What year? What year? What age?
Whereas if you go to the whereas if you go to the hadith, Aisha testifies that Muhammad took her into his house when she was still playing with dolls. A little baby girl playing with dolls. Muhammad, there is a hadith. Listen, note, everything I say, I have proof, right? Muhammad used to go into Aisha's room while she was playing with dolls with her friends. Huh? A group of little girls playing with dolls.
Disgusting. Give me the hadith.
He used to go into her room.
Disgusting.
And when he went into her room, the girls would leave. And when Muhammad was finished, the girls would come back.
Disgusting.
Now use your brain. Disgusting. This is a girl of 6 years old being visited by a 50 odd year old man.
Arab man.
This is your great example that you should follow. Wagwan.
That's disgusting, man.
This is your great example. Is that the best you can do? Look to Jesus Christ. There was no guile found in him. He's the way, the truth, and the life. There was no sin found in him. He fulfilled every prophecy from Old Testament. He opened the eyes of the blind, never done before. Why? Not to just open the eyes of the blind, but to fulfill Old Testament prophecy, to prove he is the Messiah. Because when they tried to diss him, they couldn't diss him because they said, how can a man demon-possessed open the eyes of the blind? Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise be the Lord, brother.
They knew he had the power of God. They knew he was sinless. They knew he claimed to be God. They knew they couldn't accuse him of sin.
He never claimed.
They could not accuse him of sin. So what did they have to do? They had to go and give him a kangaroo court. They put him in a kangaroo court.
He's a liar.
And brought false witnesses to convict him of a crime he didn't commit. Little did they know they were playing into the hands of the Almighty Yahweh God in heaven. Because it was prophesied that Jesus would go to the cross and he would not utter a word. When they asked him time and time again, tell us plainly, are you the Christ? He didn't want to expose it. Not until the right time. When the demons recognized him, he shut their mouths. To the demon, when he walked into a room, the demons fell on their faces. They knew who he was. They'd cry out and throw the ones they possessed into the fire. And they'd cry out, oh, Son of God, have you come to torment us before the time? Jesus shut their mouths and cast them out. because he wasn't ready to be known, because he had to fulfill prophecy. But when he was in that kangaroo court, after Judas betrayed him, after he fulfilled every prophecy, after he prayed to the Father for strength, it was time to reveal who he was. And when they asked him, tell us plainly, if you're the Son of God, are you the Blessed One? He said, I am. He said, I am. And you will see the Son of Man come in fire and the holy power of the angels. And that's all it took for them to rip their clothes, spit in his face, and take him to the cross. That was the plan. The plan of God from since man fell in Genesis to reconcile mankind to himself, to send his only begotten Son. He said, God will come and remove all ungodliness from the house of Jacob. And that's what he did. Turn to Jesus Christ. Stop following a fake prophet. Stop following a child molester. Stop following a bewitched man. Stop following a liar. Stop following a thief. Stop following a rapist. Accuse the man I call the best example, Jesus Christ, of something. Accuse him. You can't accuse him because he was a pure lamb, a spotless lamb, the Passover lamb, the sinless lamb, the one that your Quran says is a pure boy, a holy boy, a righteous son.
Amen, brother. Christ is King.
Let's cut off this thing now, yeah? Cut off this thing. I met them now.
Very good, all your snakes, man, right here. Because you know why? Even your own scripture.
Look at this Muslim, proud of his prophecy.
Test every single spirit.
Proud of his
Because they came in the name of God, but they are the father of the devil. Because you know why? Who is Jesus to you? Who is Jesus? Is the Alpha, the Omega, is he God or Son of God? Or is he prophet? Why is he too many claims? Or is he the Son of Man? You tell me. Or is it the Son of Man?
Like in Daniel, yes, the prophecy. It's a vision. So he's coming like the Son of Man.
He's God,
like
the Son of God.
He's the Alpha,
he's the Omega.
Amen, hallelujah, well done.
And he's prophet like unto months. How many claims is that? Come on. If you take this to court, yeah, and bring the police officer, they'll tell you this will be horse crap. I'll tell you where you've got this from. I'll tell you where you got from. You stole them from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and Ishmael, you know, when God said, sacrifice your son when he was testing him, yeah?
That's right.
And when he was about to do it, bought a lamb. You stole them from that and twisted. You also stole them from the Romans.
Do you sleep with children?
Remember, hold on. The book of Romans, why is that there?
Do you sleep with children?
Why is the book of Romans in there? And who killed Jesus? That's the
truth. Do you sleep with children?
Because you don't believe in Jesus died. The Messiah can never die. How can the anointed one die? You tell me that today.
Are you just heckle and run?
Watch him run. A shame. He's probably got a 6-year-old at home somewhere. God help him.
Anyway,
it's not a joke. Serious thing, mate. Serious matter. Serious matter.
Hey, Paul. How are you, Paul?
He won't debate about Muhammad. My brother Arul tried to debate this man for weeks. Weeks and weeks and weeks. And he kept my dear brother Arul full of grace on the topic of whether Jesus is God for weeks. And he refused to debate about Muhammad. No, he won't debate about Muhammad. Muslims are too afraid.